Hey there everybody, good to see y'all again. This video's been a long time coming. We already showed how to export Supernote notebooks to Excalidraw. Today we'll tackle the other half of the loop, importing from Excalidraw back into Supernote. Yep, that means we've finally gone full circle and in a way freed the Supernote format. You no longer need a Supernote tablet or even the Note app to read, tweak, or create a note file. That opens the door to real collaboration with folks who don't own a Supernote. Okay, since there's a bunch to cover, we're going to switch a bit the format and let Valerie, aka Vivi, jump in with questions I figure most of y'all will have. Quick disclaimer, I'm keeping things simple here, and I might be a little biased. Feel free to set me straight in the comments. Go ahead, Vivi.
Hi, everyone. Okay. What exactly is Excalidraw, and why would a Supernote user bother with it?
Excalidraw is an open-source whiteboard that runs right in your browser. There's even a plugin for Obsidian that adds extra goodies. Picture an infinite canvas where you can drop text, freehand drawings, images, and shapes, then move, resize, or edit them any way you like. What makes it interesting for Supernote folks is the data format. Everything on that canvas is just a tidy list of JSON objects, and instead of exporting flat PDFs or images, we're exporting penstroke vectors. That gives you true editability, resize handwriting, change colors, etc., straight in the browser. And when you go the other way, Excalidraw offers editing tricks the tablet can't yet do. Drop in text or images, recolor fonts, build mind maps and diagrams you'll see in the demo.
So SNEX is basically a bridge, moving pen strokes back and forth as vector points. Is that right?
Mostly. 99% of the time, Supernote exports pen strokes, lines, curves, your scribbles. One exception, when the tablet does handwriting recognition, that recognized text exports as plain text, not strokes. Coming back from Excalidraw, text and shapes are usually turned into vector points before they land in a Supernote notebook. The one other wrinkle is images. Only SVGs become pen strokes. PNGs and JPEGs get imported as a locked-down background layer, positioned and sized perfectly, but not editable. SNEX automates the same workaround folks already use for background templates.
Got it, but Excalidraw is just a giant canvas. How do you handle pages, and how does SNEX know where to put each element when you go back to Supernote?
These are all good questions. SNEX fakes pages by dropping labeled frames, one frame per Supernote page. By default, they stack top to bottom, though there's an option to lay them side by side if that suits you. If you're starting a brand new notebook right in Excalidraw, just ask SNEX for a blank template. All you need to do is type python snex.py --blank, and that'll generate an empty Excalidraw file under a blank subfolder.
Hold up. You said command. Do I have to use a terminal?
Afraid so, yeah.
I'm not exactly a terminal wizard.
No worries. Pop open a terminal in the folder where snex.py is located, then type python snex.py --help. You'll see every option spelled out, no programming degree required.
I see. Looks like a lot, though.
Really, you only need two things. For conversion, or running a file through the bridge, the optional command is --file, but it's not required. The other thing is creating a template using that --blank we just talked about. Everything else is fine-tuning.
Okay, so I right-click the folder, choose Open in Terminal, and every command starts with python snex.py. Got it. If I hand snex a .note, it exports to Excalidraw. If I hand it a .excalidraw, it goes the other way?
Exactly. The script figures it out from the file extension. You can also keep your settings in config/usersettings.json. just like Python. The command line's great for checking what each option does, and if you ever mess things up, --reset puts all the defaults back.
Anything else that's notably different from Python?
Yes, one biggie. You move the files around. SNEX won't pull from or push to the tablet for you.
Oh no, why'd you drop that?
Couple reasons. First, I wanted to break features into smaller projects instead of piling everything on Python. Makes the code cleaner for other devs. Second, SNEX should work for people who don't own a Supernote. You could email your raw .note file to someone. They convert it, mark it up, convert it back. No tablet needed.
Wow, that really does free the format. Could make cross-platform automation a breeze.
That's the idea, assuming other platforms open up too. And just wait, RADA has some major updates cooking. Can't spill details, but they're going to be game changers.
Tease. All right, what else can Excalidraw do?
Plenty. Drop elements anywhere. Load them with text or images. Build mind maps with anchored connectors. They follow the shapes. Switch elbow styles. All that good stuff. The Obsidian plugin goes even further. I haven't scratched the surface yet. When exporting from Supernote to Excalidraw, we saw how you can visually search your handwritten notes. Like here, for instance, my Python notebook that I uploaded in Obsidian with the Excalidraw plugin. The OCR from the Supernote is superimposed on an invisible layer, but remains searchable.
Yes, that's cool indeed. One more question. You've only tested on the Manta so far, right?
Yep. In theory, it works on every Supernote model, but if you hit a snag, file a bug report.
Okay, no more questions from me. Show us some cool stuff.
All right, folks. First thing you got to do is install SNEX. Head over to the GitHub repo, scroll down to the installation section, and you'll see three little commands. Copy them, open a terminal, paste, hit enter, and you're done. The installer drops an alice.excalidraw demo file in XC2SN. We'll start with that file. I'm using the free Excalidraw site for this first run. My paid account has fancier sharing options, but every feature you need works just fine in the free version, okay? Fire up Excalidraw in your browser. Click the hamburger menu, then open, then load from file. Navigate to alice.excalidraw and open it. If the canvas looks empty at first, don't panic. That's just because Excalidraw opens at 100% zoom. You could switch the interface ratio in SNEX settings to 50% or 33%, but that risks losing detail when we bounce the file back and forth between Excalidraw and the Supernote. Instead, hold the Control key and scroll your mouse wheel to zoom out, or click Scroll Back to Content. My favorite, press Shift-1 that fits the whole drawing in the window. If your notebook has a bunch of pages, everything will look tiny, but it makes navigation easy. This demo's only one page, so we're good. On this page, we've got four text boxes and one image. Click any element and a style panel pops up on the left. Up top, you've got a toolbar. Technically, the frame that simulates the page is another element. SNEX locks it by default. Let's recreate this page to illustrate the workflow. Open another browser. Excalidraw won't give you two sessions in the same app. Load the blank template. Hit Shift-1 to zoom out. Copy the chapter title and text to your clipboard. Select the text tool, paste. See how Excalidraw automatically resizes the text box? Drag the edges until the text reflows the way you want. Stay clear of the page border. Supernote gets cranky if text touches the edge. By default, SNEX picks the Excalifont font. My template used Nunito, so let's fix that. Change the chapter title to Excalifont. Leave the body text as Nunito. Supernote doesn't store fonts for pen strokes. It maps characters through an ASCII table, same trick Python uses. In usersettings.json, Excalifont is mapped to Caveat and Nunito to Barlow. On the Manta, you can also pick Sigge, Calibri, or Omid. Now let's drop in the Rabbit PNG. Click Image on the toolbar. Select the PNG. Remember, PNGs and JPEGs import as background layers. Position locked, not pen strokes. SVGs, on the other hand, do convert to strokes. Save the file back into the demo folder. Then jump to the terminal for conversion. I'm on Windows, and I chose to open a Git Bash terminal because I want to show the time it takes to run the script. So I'm adding an extra prefix, time. Okay, the conversion command for our file is python-snex.py, followed by the relative path of the Excalidraw file, demo xc2snalice2.excalidraw. SNEX sees that Excalidraw extension and knows we're going into Supernote. It took 12 seconds to complete, and you can see a .note file right beside your Excalidraw document, ready to be uploaded onto the tablet. So let me just copy that new file and paste it onto the Supernote folder. As usual, we need to recycle the placeholder, and here's our Supernote notebook. A word about the text conversion. We revamped a bit the text to pen stroke algorithm, so the resulting pen strokes are a bit better looking. The settings for a font family has more parameters. Vertical are vertical offsets. You can now also define a word and row separator per font. I should probably reshuffle this a bit in a future version because delta X and word separator are actually horizontal distances. Narrowing before and narrowing after allow to fine-tune the space after a given character. Lastly, weight defines the pen thickness for a range of font sizes. If we go back to the execution log, we can see the Excalidraw size of the various text boxes. For example, the box with Chapter 1 was using Barlow characters with a size of 73. Similarly, the box with the text starting with Down the Rabbit was a caveat font with a size of 52. Knowing those ranges, you can fine-tune some ranges in the font JSON to adapt a certain thickness for a given font size range. There are further parameters for the width and high of each character based on the canvas scale resolution, where a 2 means that you see the same as a 50% zoom. But as I briefly mentioned before, changing this will degrade the resolution when you start going back and forth between the two platforms. So it's better to keep the screen ratio parameter to 1. Here is a notebook with some variation of font mappings that I applied to the title and body. One more thing on this fonts customization topic. A few months ago, I wrongly advised to trace ASCII fonts by trying to minimize the number of pen strokes per character. In retrospect, the most important factor is to trace using a natural way. This is the major factor for the Supernote built-in text recognition engine. So if you want your imported text to be recognized, you got to pay attention to the way you trace the characters, okay? All right, let's talk about importing images. We saw that PNGs and JPGs are imported as background layers. Here I have an Excalidraw file with a wiki note about painted Easter eggs. The image on the right is a PNG, while the one on the left is an SVG. By the way, there are multiple websites offering free images in both SVG or JPG-PNG format, but you can also use the excellent free software Inkscape to create an SVG version about anything. Let's run SNEX. You can see that the execution takes some time. You'll notice that the notebook file is also huge. This is because the extraction of pen strokes and their conversion to the Supernote is computer intensive. Also, just a warning here. Contrary to Python, there is no filtering or simplification here, so please avoid this for anything complex or with dense areas. Keep it for simple images. Okay, it's done. Look at that file size. Let's open in the Supernote. The eggs on the left image come from the SVG image, and we can select them indeed. Let me pick my preferred egg and resize it a bit. And voila! All right, folks, that's almost it for today. What follows is an example going back and forth between the two platforms. First, by importing a database icon sheet into the Supernote, then by adding the individual stickers from the Supernote in the Excalidraw library. Note that this requires a subscription plan, but you can get a free trial. I then created an example of a database infrastructure using connectors before exporting again to Supernote. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. In the meantime, happy converting.